Justice Department recently informed Donald Trump's legal team that he is a target of a federal investigation into possibly mishandling classified documents. What's your reaction to the news about your former boss?
Look, I don't know the facts of the president's case. I don't know the facts of the former president's case. But what we've got to have in this country is equal treatment under the law.
Equal treatment under the law. It seems like Mike Pence believes that, you know, we shouldn't treat Trump as if he's above the law. We shouldn't treat anyone who is elite or powerful as if they're above the law, right? Except no. That is not what he's saying. He's trying to make a point that there's somehow a double standard in our justice system when it comes to prosecuting Trump after he took classified and top secret documents home with him, and prosecuting Biden when he inadvertently did so and immediately turned over the classified documents as soon as they were discovered. So let's hear more of what he had to say.
When I informed the Department of Justice that we had classified materials potentially in our home, they were at my home. The FBI was on my front doorstep the next day.
But isn't
what we found out was that when Joe Biden apparently alerted the Department of Justice, 80 days later, they showed up at his office. That's not equal treatment under the law.
Sir, and we've got to end. I understand you're talking about equal treatment.
So in other words, this is yet another opportunity for Mike Pence to, you know, remember that he's running against Trump. And so he doesn't have to provide cover for Trump the way he did when he was serving as vice president in Trump's administration. Instead, he gets scared. He runs away from trying to, you know, answer the question. And you can tell he's nervous. You could tell he's freaking out about this conversation because he doesn't want to take any jabs at Trump. Just by the way he breathes heavily. If you don't know what I mean, take a look at the next clip.
But the question is, allegation that an investigation into obstruction, which you clearly did not do, if that is something that investigators see as possible, even enough potentially to indict the former president, do you think that that should go forward?
Well, I would hope not.
I would hope not. That's what I do sometimes when you go on a rant that I disagree with. I'm like on the side. Anyway, we're gonna get to his elaboration on why he would hope not in just a moment. But Cenk, what are your thoughts?
You know, I know he's a Christian, but maybe maybe he's doing some sort of breathing exercises there, some sort of meditation or something. Like, oh, that we're talking about Trump again. I remember when that guy tried to execute me. Okay, but I can't insult him too much because the base loves him.
Stop making that face.
I mean, I thought the first one was funnier though, when he was like,
yeah, he struggles. You can tell he's nervous. He can't find the words. He's like hyperventilating a little bit.
Okay, dude, you ain't gonna win. You ain't gonna win. Go home. Go home to mother. Go home to mother, please. I'm begging you. The dude tried to get you killed, and you're still like, well, I think he's, well, you know, I think we could be above the law, should be above the law. I mean, we should have equal protection law, except for Trump. Trump, when he tries to murder people like me, he should be above the law.
Okay. All right, since we're just making fun of him, why don't we go to the next video where he explains why he does not want Trump to be indicted, even though there's a lot of evidence indicating that he willingly, knowingly took classified documents with him to Mar-a-Lago. Let's watch.
I think it would be terribly divisive to the country. I mean, at a time when the American people are hurting, I mean to tell you, families are struggling right now with record inflation. We have a crisis at our border, the likes of which we've never seen. We have a flood of fentanyl coming into every city, large and small, in this country that's killing young people every day. We have threats abroad, a crime wave in our cities. I think now more than ever, we ought to be finding ways we could actually come together.
And sir, we're going to get
and
to
this
all
kind of this kind of action by the Department of Justice, I think, would only fuel further division in the country. And let me also say, I think it would also send a terrible message to the wider world. I mean, we're the emblem of democracy. We're the symbol of justice in the world.
Right. So it would somehow send a bad message to the world if the United States for once didn't have a two-tier justice system and ensure that everyone who breaks the law gets treated equally, right? The former president of the United States, it appears, broke the law in a very serious way, taking home with him top secret documents that can only be reviewed in secure government facilities. He took that home with him and then lied about how he declassified those documents, which was a joke. But no, I mean, it sends a good message to the world if we just do not do anything about that and allow the president to get away with the crimes.
But it's so much worse than that because it was him. They were trying to kill him. It's not even theoretical, right? Like if they were chanting, hang Cenk Uygur, right? I wouldn't, and the guy said to his chief of staff, Donald Trump said to his chief of staff, you know, that he didn't mind it. He didn't mind it. If somebody said that about people trying to kill me, I wouldn't be I was gonna use a very harsh word, but let's say I wouldn't be Ken Doll, Mike Pence going,
providing cover for Trump.
Yeah, I'd be right now kicking the living crap out of him. I'd be talking about how you gotta put this son of a bitch in prison. He tried to get me killed. This is the weakest man in America. Please go home to mother. When I was watching the NBA championship the other day, the same day that this town hall is happening. So I flipped to the town hall because I'm a political guy to see how he's doing. And I was like, I was on there for about 13 seconds and I nearly fell asleep in that 13 seconds. I was like, oh my God.
Well,
okay,
yeah, I mean, you were getting some good instruction on breathing exercises and sometimes true. It can help you sleep. God, yeah.
He's so dull, he's so fake. I think maybe there's a leak in the machine, like in the back or something. And that's why he's like, has to refill the engines like from whichever factory they built him in. So this is deeply, deeply embarrassing. And the faux squint too, like, well, Dana. Like that faux squint, I can't stand it. Everything about this guy, 0% chance of winning, go home.
Now, with that said, obviously we see quite a bit of cowardice in the context of a town hall. However, interestingly enough, a pro-Pence PAC known as Committed to America put out a pretty harsh ad that really did attack Trump aggressively. So let's take a look at that.
A president begging him to ignore the Constitution. A mob shouting for him to die. And an anxious nation watching for one man to do what's right. A weak man appeases a mob. A man of courage and character stands up to them. That day, one man failed the test of leadership, while another stood tall. And since then, this so-called leader has continued to abandon our conservative principles. Now, with a woke mob trying to take away our freedom, we need a president who won't flinch.
True, we need a president who won't flinch. I mean, if this was the strategy that the Pence campaign wanted to go with, you gotta do the follow through, right? You can't just put out the ads, and that was a good ad.
Yeah.
But you can't just put out the ads and then like you freak out once you're doing debates in town halls and you're getting questions about Trump. You have to follow through, but he doesn't seem like he's willing to do it, doesn't seem like he's capable of doing it.
Cue up the first video that we showed again, but let me say this first. Look, it's a good ad and then he calls Trump weak, it's aggressive. It's not a great political strategy in the Republican side, if I have to say it, and I do. Our job is to be honest with you guys, to attack the rioters, because the Republicans love the rioters. So when he says he stood up to the mob, he's gonna lose like 65% of Republican voters instantly. They love that mob. So it's a very poor strategy.
Point. I didn't think about that, yeah. You're right.
So in that sense, but I like the strength of the ad shows, but I guarantee you the minute that you ask Mike Pence about it. Oh, a super PAC, your super PAC basically called Trump weak. What do you think about that? He's gonna go, and he's gonna backpedal. He's gonna go backpedal, right? Yeah. So then what's the point? You're just hiding behind your PAC. And it's, so look at the first video again. Look at how much he hems and haws and how weak he is. So ironic, watch.
the Justice Department recently informed Donald Trump's legal team that he is a target of a federal investigation into possibly mishandling classified documents. What's your reaction to the news about your former boss?
Look, I don't know the facts of the president's case. I don't know the facts of the former president's case. But what we've got to have in this country is equal treatment under the law.
There's almost even a little bit of a whimper there.
Yeah, there was a whimper.
There was a little whimper. Yeah, it's not good.
My super bag says Donald Trump's weak. What do I think of Donald Trump? Ain't gonna cut it, brother. Jeez. And definitely not in a Republican primary.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.